Measuring the RPM of a rotating system can have certain challenges. Dropouts can occur due to imperfections in zebra tape or due to dirt or other items getting in the way of the sensors. You can also have anomalies that occur once per rotation. It's possible to fix many of these RPM issues with post-processing tools. Here I am in Test Lab Time Data Selection. If I view one of these problem RPMs, I can see that it has an occasional spike. I go to Tools Add-ins and I add in this case, Time Data Editor. I get a toolbar, and in this toolbar, I can highlight the spike in the RPM, highlight the trace that I want to remove the spike from, and use the replace function to replace that spike by a straight line. And I can also do that without having the settings dialog box come up. So in this case, I'm highlighting it again, highlighting the trace, I hit replace, and it went ahead and did it without the dialog. I also have buttons here where I can undo the edit operations I did, and I can redo them as well. Now I'll grab a different problem RPM. And in this case, when I go to view it, we can see that we have some spikes here that are occurring once per rotation. In the time signal calculator, which I can add in via tools add-ins, pick time signal calculator here, I now can go to function tackle moments, spike removal to RPM, hit OK, hit calculate, and now I'm viewing that trace overlaid with the original, and it has removed the spikes from the data.